I cannot with Bro Beast. My God.
You do.
No, no. Rowan updated their Ford cosplay and... Oh my God. I'm a simp.
That lighting is amazing.
Yeah. Woo! I've already asked them to marry me once.
I'm telling Dented Helmet.
No, don't tell Dented Helmet. Neither of them need to know.
I'm telling.
I say we're live on Twitch.
Yep, that's kind of why I did that.
I am emotionally cheating on my simps.
I'm telling Daniel Logan. That's it.
No! Don't tell my dad. Don't tell Dad on me. He doesn't need to know.
I keep waiting for you to slip and say "daddy" instead of "dad" and be like, "Hey, did you know?"
No.
But just the way you're going, I'm like, it's gonna slip.
No.
The Boba Fett is gonna come out and it's gonna be like, oh boy.
Okay. Boba Fett is daddy. Daniel Logan is dad, because Daniel Logan is an actual person.
Fair. And I appreciate that you unlike some,
yeah,
can separate.
Yeah, I will never address actual people with the term daddy. Characters, however.
That's how I feel about young Obi-Wan Kenobi. Daddy Wan Kenobi.
That's my Bloodborne character.
Ewan McGregor is dad.
Ewan McGregor is dad. And like, more McGregor than anything, Ewan McGregor, I would love to give him a hug.
Yeah.
I feel like Alice is judging us with the Daddy Wan Kenobi thing. Yeah. Every time we say it.
100%. Every time.
Every time I say it, I feel like there's a part of him who's respects.
Simp after him when he's a young man. I don't care if y'all like him when he's a young man. Obi-Wan Kenobi is an old man. He is an elder. He is an old ass man.
I think you're talking daddy? About. Uh-uh. You're gonna be. You're talking about Ben Kenobi, not Obi-Wan Kenobi.
No, yeah. I mean Obi-Wan Kenobi. Y'all be sipping after him and calling him daddy, and I'm like, he is just as much
look,
an old
look,
man.
Look,
as
he's Daddy Wan Kenobi, okay?
He's totally Daddy Wan Kenobi. I don't care.
No, he is not. He is an elder. He is an old man. An old man.
Here's to me hoping my supervisor Jeremy never finds this stream, because he's such a huge Star Wars fan and he'd probably judge me at work. It's funny enough, he and I were discussing Obi-Wan Kenobi at work and how he almost fucking fell to the dark side. And I'm like, oh, this is news to me. You explain. He's like, well, it involved Tusken Raiders. I'm like, oh, that, of course. Of course.
Of course it does.
Also, just so you know,
it's always the Tusken Raiders.
Always the Tusken Raiders.
Just so you know, your voice mod did work earlier when you switched to it, so before you ask.
All right. Oh, I kept auto-tuning while I was talking to Mitch because I kept pressing V on my keyboard on accident.
All right.
I mean, sorry. Off topic. I know the problem is always Tusken Raiders, but I mean, just throw a crate dragon in there and we'll be fine.
The DM will remember this.
Now, when you say crate dragon, do you mean a crate dragon, or Mera Vis? Because her alias is crate dragon.
No, no. The one that the Mandalorian fought.
Oh, fuck.
Again.
I'd rather fight that than my mom.
Again, the DM will remember this.
I'd rather fight that than my mom.
Yeah.
Also, because we were on the subject. Ah! Focus, you...
I saw a perfect male specimen. That's all I saw.
What? Ewan McGregor just literally think Star Wars had a perfect male specimen.
Yes. Yes. Absolutely, 100%.
Yep.
All right.
Hello, everybody. As you can tell, we're deprived.
And the DM is judging them all harshly.
That's just like, oh my God, yes.
I just sometimes a motherfucker just needs a hug, and we're no exception.
Yeah.
Welcome everyone to session 9 of Outer Rim Misfits, guys. We actually made it to almost 10 sessions.
Holy shit!
Tonight we'll be wrapping up where they left off last week, where that was seeking out Maz Kanata's droid companion Emmy. The Misfits have discovered an underground temple of sorts with things. I'm not going to give too much background because you'll see it all in the crawl and in the recap. But reminder to all of you guys, this is meant to be a game among friends. We base majority of it on canon, but we sprinkle all the juicy stuff from Legends where it's needed to add flavor. To anyone in chat, you are allowed to discuss what you enjoy about Star Wars. We encourage that because it's Star Wars. But also remember, like, we don't want any unactual. That stuff can stick with all the gatekeeping else. We don't need that. I don't think I have any announcements, but if anyone else does, they can throw those up before we dive into things.
We have merch coming this Friday.
That.
Yes. If any of you follow me on TikTok, I gave the sneak peek of our logo. It is a wanted poster with the headshots of all 5 characters. That'll be coming to the GKC Teespring store this Friday. I have the Teespring linked here on Twitch and in my link tree. So check it out this Friday. We'll have t-shirts, stickers, posters, all the whole shebang.
Yeah, do the thing.
Want it. Get alive.
I need to learn that on guitar. I really do.
I'm low key. Wondering if I should torture myself into learning 2D animation into 2D animate an opening.
I'm not gonna stop you. Also, Mitch just said, no, that song is on 12 strings, so good luck.
I have my ways.
Just letting you know, it's a 12 string.
Trust me, I have my ways.
He has his ways. He knows the way.
Because do you know do way. We?
That's
do
you know do we?
I thought that meme died in the fucking 2012s.
No, the meme came back when we started saying, this is the way.
Oh my god.
This is the way.
Was
there?
Have you seen that guy on TikTok?
I have.
Oh my god, he's amazing. He's got like this Monty Python voice. He's like, a reading from the book of Luke.
Oh, I follow him. A reading from the book of Obi-Wan.
And then at the end of every video it goes, this is the way. It's great.
Minus the merch, was there other things we had to remember to bring up? I personally am not remembering anything, but if you guys do, please jump on
Tales
that.
Tales of Yggdrasil is tomorrow on Mitch's channel.
That's
yep. So be sure to tune in.
Still in the process of merch ideas, and I will update you guys as such. And starting next week, I will be getting back into streaming a little bit more regularly as well, so be on the lookout. Mm-hmm.
And Fridays, as always, are GKC. If you tuned in last Friday, we started with a battle, and we ended at the start of another one. So this episode's gonna go straight into combat as soon as we start on Friday. So that's fun. I pissed off a ghost priest. Now we have to fight his shadow monster.
You also pissed off
only
the half-orc.
Only you, though, Paige. Only you.
Hey, Sierra had a day. All right, she's had a day.
We fought him first. We got smacked some.
Yeah, but you kind of pissed him off by doing that.
True, but I will say I'm very proud of my bean. She did a good job with the smack.
Oh my god!
if we didn't piss him off, he would have been on your way to your AS.
Yeah.
And then you'd have.
I was waiting. I was
twice.
Like.
Okay, who else was kind of, I think even Nate was thrown off that he got a how do you want to do this? everyone was thrown off by that. Like, they were like, what?
What?
There, this has to be a trap. There's no way he got off that easily. And then Icarus smirked, and I'm like, yep, yep, he's coming back.
Oh, yep.
Oh, yeah, you betcha. Like, even Nate was surprised. Oh, he was like, holy... Nate was like, holy fuck, I killed him?
Even I was like, wait.
He was like, Nate... did I do it non-lethally? It's
like, yeah, he was like, no. I don't want to kill him. And Icarus was like, nope. And he's like, okay. That was an awesome moment though. Like, oh my god, fun. He's dead.
And then there's
Chunky. He's dead. And then I was like, okay, if Isla doesn't off these next two guys, I'm gonna riot.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We got that guy out of the way. Isla needs to take out the next two. My god.
Yeah. Luckily, Drax makes short work of them.
Yeah. Isla got to be a top. Stay.
That's right, she did. She went, sit, stay.
And Drax was terrifyingly turned on.
All right, we should probably get into the opening crawls.
Before we do that, we have to let Hannah do her wholesome.
Ah.
Will she have a plushy guest this week or just her?
No, it's just me today.
Okay.
Let me get up and greet you.
Okay.
Let me get a little sip of my tea.
That episode.
It's like a reward.
Ow. Hi. I just want to let y'all know that I think y'all are fantastic and wonderful and pleasant to be around, and I think y'all are amazing. And also, y'all are the baddest fucking bitches I've ever met. And if anybody tells you otherwise, they can fucking come and talk to me. Because I got this new chair, and I ain't messing around no more. So, if anybody gives you any kind of fucking slack, you just tell them to shut the fuck up, and y'all live your best lives. Or better yet, I can just go and burn their houses down. Because, you know, people like that don't deserve to live under a roof. So, anyway. Just remember, you're, like, the baddest bitches ever. You're amazing. You're smart. You're talented. You're enough. You are valid. You are amazing. Don't ever forget it. And continue being the badass bitches that you are. Because we need more people like you in this world. You were shaped in love. You were created in love. And you are love. Okay? And then guys!
That went from wholesome to yandere in less than 12 parsecs.
I just need to say, for legal reasons, Hannah will not be burning down houses. So whatever watch list we just fell on...
You stole my thing! You stole my thing!
Also, hi Tony, we're doing great.
Hi Tane.
For all intents and purposes and legal reasons, this was a joke.
Yes. I would say it's more hyperbole.
Please understand that I'm a very kind person and that I won't actually burn people's houses down because that's illegal and I don't want to get sued.
Also, she lives in Florida.
That's a lot of paperwork we don't want to deal with.
As she lives in Florida, she doesn't want to become Florida woman.
we already have enough crazy people here.
And plus, none of us can afford bail.
Yeah.
Yet. If you wish to contribute, though, to our get Hannah a jail fund, please do so.
I'll proceed from the Teespring go to Hannah's bail bond.
It'll be
needed. No, instead of a bail bond, just make it go towards my custom sword that I want.
She's like, I'll do the time. Worry about the sword. Hmm? This is a person who has standards.
This is a person who has priorities.
Yes.
All right, the opening crawl is ready if everyone else is.
All right, turn off your flash, you fucking moron.
Yes. I really love this part. Okay.
So we have several questions about that cave.
Don't worry about it.
It's fine.
Again, nothing to worry. You nothing to worry about.
This is fine.
But it exploded.
As the crawl suggested, and for those who watched, remember the cave did have a bit of a spontaneous combustion.
It blew up.
Yeah, it was a cave-in.
Yeah. But thankfully, none of you were hurt. Emmy is sick fine. And you got what you needed. Well, what Emmy was there for. The scene is yours.
I imagine the cave is dusty as all fuck from the explosion.
A bit. I would say there's a bit of coughing, because, you know.
Yeah, Chloe's going to look to the cave in from like, where the explosion happened, just go.
I have a ventilator in my mask, I'm fine.
Well then. That was a thing.
Yeah, that definitely was a thing.
Is everyone alright, at least?
I'm fine. That was not how I wanted it to go, but here we are.
Well, I would say, let's not tell Maz about the underground shit and the cave-in, but something tells me she's going to find out sooner or later.
Might as well tell her now.
I can try contacting her again.
It's up to you.
Roll me a wisdom.
Oh, shit! That's a dirty 20.
Hey!
You do your best. You can feel her like you had in the past, but she's not responsive. As if either she's just ignoring you, can't speak, or something. You can feel her, but she's not receiving the call. Please leave a message after the beep.
I think Mars just put me on voicemail.
I mean, how many times have you bugged her with that weird magic telepathic stuff again?
Okay, to be fair, the first one was by accident. The second time was because I didn't exactly want Kierra to steal a book that she didn't Mars didn't want stolen. This time, she kind of needs to know.
Alright, when you say first time was an accident, what were you trying to do? Was it with those people that we saw on the castle?
Yeah.
I don't think you ever fully explained to me what you were trying to do when we were walking out.
I was just trying to get a grasp of them to see what they were about.
They... Well, obviously that buckethead was about muscle oil and trying to look like he's the hottest shit on the planet.
No.
That Twi'lek like, looked like she was like goth mode or something.
Nice advertisement. They knew that what they were doing. They were smart. They knew exactly what they needed. They knew exactly what they wanted. They knew exactly how to get it.
Question is, what are they wanting and how are they going to get it?
We should head back.
We gotta get Emmy back to the castle anyway, so.
Emmy, are you good?
Emmy slowly gets back up. Due to there being a protocol droid, they're not exactly built to bend like humans do. So they use their hand to prop against the wall and start like levering themselves up slowly. After a moment, they look around going, oh, that was loud. I seem to be functional still, though. So whenever you are ready, we can head back.
I want to look Emmy over. Did they take, like, any bad damage from the,
the explosion?
Yeah.
Roll a perception.
Oh, goody. Let's see if my curse continues tonight.
While Phaisa was doing that, Shez, Boz, you all good?
Bad.
Yes, I am. I think I'm alright. Fun times hurling a robot through a door, so.
Good job on that, by the way. That came in clutch.
Thank you.
Buzz, no damage?
All clear.
Alright, I rolled a 14 for perception.
You don't notice anything drastically damaged, like no new like chunks missing or parts hanging out. But you also know that when you first found her, she looked like she was older, worn. So if there was anything there, it's not new.
Okay. All right. Good to know.
Yeah. She's got some mileage on.
Yeah.
She's old.
Hey, never call a woman old.
Never call a woman old.
Seasoned.
Yeah, it's close.
That just sounds like something a cannibal would say.
True.
Oh, gosh. Yeah, I'm not sure if that's much better.
I think this is one of the situations where no matter what you say, Mitch, hole.
Dude, I've been in a hole for the past decade.
So, yes. So, you guys are just going to leave as is, or are you going to do anything in here before you depart?
Nothing Phaisa wants to look at around here.
Alright.
Klorgu is very much a case of, okay, we have Emmy, we have the new data, let's fuck off.
Same here.
Perfectly fine. Shez and Boz, you guys in the same boat?
Yeah.
I want to take a rock.
Like a specific rock or just a rock?
One that would obviously fit in my backpack.
Okay. Roll... I guess roll investigation, see if you can find a good one.
Why?
I'm seeing him like that would be perception.
Can I see what Boz is doing and assist him with it?
I would say yeah, you could see, because you have
all right.
You have your night vision.
Alright, Boz, vision. Roll with advantage.
17.
Hey!
Not bad.
You scoot some of the rocks away. A lot of them just crumble as you move them. But after you do that for a minute or so, a really sturdy one about the size of your palm you can find. And on it, you can actually see some of the etched in writing that was on the wall previously when the room was solid. so you can say you actually have something from the temple and not just some random rock.
Picking up a souvenir, boss?
Something like that.
He's gonna, yeah, use it. He's gonna use it. Call it.
All I'm saying is Brock doesn't need ammunition.
The BBEG is gonna die because Ba's gonna pull up the rock and be like, I've been waiting so many sessions for this.
It's like that TikTok audio with the BBEG. It's like, it started in the hay, laughed a coop and will it just started in the hay. Constant Ba's with a rock.
Oh my god.
All I'm saying is, I can just see Ba's reaching to his pocket and be like, I've waited all game for this. Starts beating the BBEG with the rock.
Yes.
Don't maybe use this.
Yeah.
Alright, so after that, I'm assuming I'm just gonna make their way out. No muss, no fuss. Yeah. Alright.
Yep.
Once you guys retreat back to the outside, you've discovered that it is now night. The forest's a lot stranger when there's no sun out. The noise of wildlife seems a bit more precocious. And you suddenly realize, because there's no sun, you guys actually are further from the castle than you realized, because you can't see it through the trees and all that.
Thanks, Eric.
I'm usually good with seeing in the dark, so this is worrisome.
We walked a little further than we expected.
We did chat a lot while walking.
I mean, we did pick up a chicken along the way.
Actually, speaking of, that reminds me. Shez, please roll me an animal handling. I mean, after all the stuff they just went through, Morrison Duvet is probably very traumatized by the room exploding. Like, we gotta see if that animal is, like, having some,
Outer Rim Misfits, experts at giving droids anxiety and traumatizing chickens.
I love it. Hang on. Okay. I thought my D20 was already out, but it's not. And also, my Wi-Fi is terrible. So
making me wonder if the Outer Rim Misfits have give good dental.
They don't even have good dental.
Meanwhile, Boz, I don't even have teeth.
I don't have a skull.
Or bones. Oh, look, I've been impaled.
Look at her face froze, yeah. Like half-lidded.
Yeah.
Oh, no. Do you think you could pull my character sheet up faster than I can?
Yes. Hi.
This is why I have my character sheet as a bookmark.
My Wi-Fi is...
Oh, no.
I meant you pull it up on your own devices because it's been loading for eternity. No, I didn't know. I know what to do here. I was hoping that you could pull... Yes. Yeah. My...
This is like Uncanny Valley right here. I could hear them over two microphones.
I was gonna say it's not a true stream unless there's one thing that goes wrong.
It's not a true stream unless there's one technical fuck up.
Oh, that's better. There it is.
Is this the episode we adopt a chicken?
Right,
we already adopted the chicken yesterday. Oh well, no. Okay. That's a 7.
7?
Oh no.
Oh no.
Poor Morrison, still clinging to you, is breathing very heavily, and you know this thing is going to be like, it's going to need to talk to a therapeutic chicken or something to get over what it just saw.
Oh gosh.
My advice would be to offer it a lot of seeds as comfort food.
Do I still have seeds with me?
Not on you, but on the way back you can look for some in the forest. Okay. If you wish to try doing a investigation as you
probably will do that.
Hey, damn, fuck.
I may have started that yawn train and I'm sorry.
Oh, no, next.
Oh, I didn't even see you yawn, Mitch. I just yawned.
Mitch, then Sela, then me, then Hannah.
That was beautiful.
Yeah.
It's a Mexican yawn.
Once you guys are outside and all, you notice that Emmy didn't wait for you. She just started walking off without you guys. And seems to be pretty confident in her ability to make her way back. Are you planning on running after her or letting her go because apparently she's fine?
Maybe we just follow the droid.
Follow her?
Okay.
He knows her way around this place.
We're following the droid, We're following the droid to head back to Maz's palace.
While you guys are going, everyone roll me perception.
Oh no.
God.
Oh no. Oh no. Oh no.
Perception.
Oh yeah.
Wow, my rolls are awful tonight. What is
what did you get? You got a four? Ooh, is that a four? Oh
good god.
She's too focused on the chicken.
Actually, you're not wrong. You are more concerned about Morrison to notice. What did you get, Phaisa?
I got another 14.
Okay. Klorgu?
15.
Yeah.
12.
And Boz?
Oh, we'll talk about it. It may or it may not. You know, subject to change, be a natural one.
Oh, God.
What do you mean by subject to change?
I mean, who knows? Schrodinger's natural one.
Oh, okay. Yeah. I love that. I love Schrodinger.
He's got a point there. He's got a point there.
Yeah. If you don't look at it, it could be anything.
Yeah, my hand over it, it doesn't exist.
Alright, so the only one of you who notices is Borgu and Kierra. You notice as you guys are walking a ship leaving orbit.
Not our ship, is it?
We tell from that distance?
I was gonna say, like,
roll a intelligence.
I swear to fucking god, if someone hijacked the mythosaur.
That's unnatural 20.
Ew. I only got 17 on that one.
Kierra, you're able to notice that the sound of the engine is distinctly different once you were aware that there was something going on. It's not the mythosaur.
Oh, thank god.
Back of Phaisa's mind. Hondo would kill me.
Well, that's certainly not our ship.
Wait, what?
A ship left for orbit. It's not ours, though. So someone didn't. The Mentosaur is still there.
She better still be there.
Right. If we point out the distinct sound difference, will Phaisa now hear it?
Now that she's looking for it, yes, she would notice it. So it will still be strange that she didn't hear the engine before, so making her wonder when did that ship arrive, let alone who's on it.
Can I make another perception to see what kind of ship it is?
You can try.
Whether it be Imperial or something.
Roll with disadvantage because you can't see the ship.
That is fair.
All you're going on is sound.
I don't even remember hearing a ship like that arriving.
My lowest was 14.
It's not a ship you've heard, so you can't distinguish it, but you know it's not Imperial.
Well, it's not an Imperial ship.
Wasn't that Corellian freighter, was it? Falcon's still here.
Actually, the Falcon is gone. It left after the battle of the two X-Wings.
That's right.
Look, I have a bad memory, all right?
You were distracted by fascists, it's fine.
If the Mythosaur was stolen, the first thing I was going to do is punch Han Solo. Because I feel like he had something to do with it.
He sold it to pay off a debt to the Conja Club.
Oh, you never make a deal with Conja Club.
No, you...
Never make a deal with Conja Club.
Anyway, go ahead.
Klorgu was just going to say, unless it's those two shady characters that were talking to Maz.
That is a possibility.
Definitely is. Best way to find out is head back to the castle, see if they're still there.
Klorgu's going to walk a little bit faster this time, just being like, okay, I need to have words with Maz.
Okay. Also, by the way, Shez, you are able to find some seeds for Morrison along the way.
Yay. Is he feeling better?
He calms down a bit. He's still a bit worked up, obviously, because that was traumatic. But he's not in the cuckoo about to summon an army to attack you mode.
That's good, at least.
Fucking cuckoos.
When you guys arrive to the palace, it's eerily quiet for a place that's usually bustling with smugglers, pirates, bounty hunters, and the like. And the doors to the palace are still open, whereas normally they were closed before you get there.
There's no smoke coming from the palace, is there?
There is no smoke.
The place doesn't have a curfew, as far as I know.
Isn't this like a 24/7 place?
Basically, Maz never really shuts the place down. She makes sure the doors shut, though, when people leave. They don't just stay wide open.
Does anyone else have a bad feeling about this?
God damn it, I was just about to say that. Fuck you.
No feelings were hurt in the making of this episode.
All of the feels were.
Bad feeling.
Klorgu's going to kind of look to everyone and be like, okay, I'm going, and runs.
Yeah.
A Phaisa will book it after.
And we're ready.
If we run past Emmy, she'll just be like, we'll meet you back at the castle.
You guys do run past Emmy, as she can only walk so fast. Running by her actually startles her a bit to go, oh my. Do be careful. I do not wish to trip anyone. And once you guys are clear past her and closer to the castle, what is going to be the order of everyone rushing in?
I'm probably going to be, like, on the very back, because I didn't get the memo until it was, like, everyone had already started running.
That's fair. You were tending to Morrison.
I'll probably be behind Klorgu.
Okay.
Yeah. Klorgu was the first to run, so he'll probably be the first in.
Phaisa will be behind Kierra.
Will Boz be running as well, or will he be just casually with Emmy?
Emmy's fine. I'll stay with everybody else.
Okay. Figured I'd check if there was going to be a casual droid stroll as everyone else is panicking.
Organics, right?
Where they're scared of everything. For those who have reached the inside, which would be the group of you, roll... roll investigation.
Shit. Holy shit.
Was that a good holy shit?
Yeah. 22.
Oh shit.
21. I got a natural 20.
We got.
Oh.
At least one of us got
a 19.
All right.
Oh, Shez.
Shez is very concerned about Morrison, so she is more like, hey, just...
What is happening? That was a 17! Where was that?
Because you weren't...
I think Hannah's going to bring you reinforcements.
Yes.
No, it's fine. It's okay.
No.
Before you deliver that, what did you get,
Kierra? As someone who has been afflicted by the curse, you do not want to just say this is fine.
I'm fine.
Are you though?
The way, dear.
While Hannah does that, Foz, what did you get for that?
I got an 11.
You got an 11? Oh, all right.
Wow, thank you.
11's not bad.
No, it's not. 11, 11's perfectly fine.
11's average. Also, I want to use this filter once. Help is on the way, dear. Help is on the way.
Here, what? How did you do on your roll?
I got a
18. Okay. So, Klorgu, Kierra, and Phaisa, you three are the first three in, and you notice everyone just seems to be asleep. Like, all the patrons are either sleeping at the tables, the bars, some on the floor. A few of them are just passed out mid-drink in their hand. Others are curled up as if, you know, it's end of the night. Phaisa, you notice, though, behind the bar, Maz is working, leaning a flask, not a flask, a pint, and kind of just chill. Klorgu, as you run in, not Klorgu, Boz, as you run in, you are actually able to notice that the door is wide open because inside, your sensors detect it is extremely warmer than normal. So the doors are open to get a cross breeze in. And it seems the heat is coming from inside the palace versus outside. And Chez, you've noticed that Morrison actually is completely calmed down by the time you guys have reached inside.
Aw, yeah! Hey, my little buddy.
Is everything okay in here, Maz?
She looks up and stares quizzically at you. Yes. Why?
Phaisa will just gesture to everything.
She looks around. Where's my droid?
She's on her way back. We noticed something seemed off, so we headed back first after we found her.
He puts the pint away. Goes around the bar, comes towards you guys. Where'd you end up finding her?
That's a long story.
He gestures to everyone around you. It seemed like I'm busy. Would you prefer to talk at the bar, or would you like to go somewhere else?
You guys want a drink?
I could use one.
I'm fine.
Is there a free booth that we can sit and talk? The one that it doesn't have sleeping patrons?
He smirks.
And Clog.
But
I was gonna say, yeah, Klorgu will actually ask that of Maz.
Okay. Yeah, she smirks. She thinks for me, and she's like, second floor, go on the terrace. There's a few tables up there you can use. No one's up there. I'll bring you all some drinks. And as you say it, Emmy actually just strolls in and casually just goes about her thing, as if she didn't even leave. Which Maz notices and goes, oh. She was behind you. Good.
What in the Nashadar?
Trust me, Nashadar is a different kettle of blowfish.
Hold on, really quick, because you said that.
Oh boy.
Maz looks at your arm, Klorgu.
My arm.
Yeah, she like grabs your arm and rolls your sleeve up. You went in the water, didn't you?
I wanted to refill my canteen.
We made a friend.
Did he name it? Tell me he named
it. No, I kind of shook it back in the water.
Well, that's just rude. Wait,
Chess named a chicken, though.
That's true. She did catch a chicken friend.
Yes, this is Sir Morrison Duvet. He's nice right now.
Pulls her goggles down over her eyes and looks at Morrison. Just letting you know. This one doesn't like... Seems like this one doesn't like men.
That is relatable.
Which is strange because he is a man. He must have had a harsh childhood.
Oh, this poor thing. That is so relatable.
But after that, Moz looks at you all. Go upstairs to the table. I'll bring your drinks. Go.
All right,
we're going.
All right. No, nothing. I just had a private realization.
Oh, okay. Go for it, Daisy.
When everyone's moving off to go upstairs, Boz wants to separate and go to the Mythosaur.
Okay. Are you going to try doing so stealthily, or are you just going to just casually, you know, swagger off?
I can't attempt stealth.
It's up to you if you wish to do stealthy.
Hey, if it suffices, you just have to beat a 12 to make sure Phaisa doesn't see you.
Yeah, I think the collective passive perception is no higher than like 13.
Yeah. Well, what a coincidence, because guess what my stealth is?
What did you get?
A 13.
Hey, you beat it!
So no one has a passive perception above 13, correct?
No.
Yeah.
I'm so proud.
At least someone's landing their rules tonight. Yeah, you were able to wait till Maz pushes everyone and you just slip back and scuttle off to the ship.
Oh, okay. Suddenly there's a Jawa.
I really was like, did I just hear that? On the way... I had to say it, but apparently on your way out, Boz, you kicked a Jawa in the face.
It's even perfect because it's Star Wars.
I just for flavor, did you kick it? Did you kick the Jawa like it owed you money?
Oh my gosh! Oh, that was so funny.
Oh, that was brilliant.
Oh my god! All right. We'll make sure it's clipped later. Continue.
Yes. Because I'm curious where this is going. Once you're in the Mythosaur, what are you going to do?
Do I know which room is Klorgu's?
Roll an intelligence.
Oh, I'm really good at that. Just straight intelligence?
Yep, just straight intelligence based on, like, memory.
That is a synthetic 20.
Ooh!
Not only do you know where it is, you know how to open the door without leaving any detection.
Well, it's not the room itself I'm interested in.
That's making me more concerned. What are you doing?
So how's the door open? Is there like a touch panel next to the door?
Yes.
I want to try and disassemble that and learn how it works and reassemble it before everyone gets back.
My DM alarm is going off a lot, but also the chaotic part of me is like, I want to see where he's going with this. Okay, roll... Just because to see how long it takes you to do this, roll me. Roll me dexterity.
Straight dexterity?
Yeah, just straight dex. To determine how nimble you are at this.
So the intelligence roll was a 17 plus 3 for a 20.
Yes.
The dexterity is 16 plus 4 for a 20.
The dice want us to know what you're planning, and I'm for it. Yeah, you're able to do this before anyone notices you're gone. Like, you're able to, like, unscrew up the panel, do your rewiring, and screw it back on as if no one even was in there.
Excellent.
You gonna clue us in on what you did? Or is this a wait-and-see moment?
This is a wait-and-see. He just walks back.
Okay. Again, the DM and me should be concerned. The chaotic side is very intrigued.
Just wanted to know how the door handle works, is all.
That's Klorgu specifically.
That's fair. That's fair in case a door ever jams.
Okay. Going back to the rest of the party. Guys, roll me a perception to see if you've noticed that Boz has not followed you up to the table upstairs.
Nope. I can't see shit.
Nope.
That's
I want
seven.
A natural one.
Hang on. Perception?
Yep.
Oh,
that's
please.
A seven for me.
Heavy duty dice. What? That's a six.
Okay. Did anyone
another six?
How did you do, Kierra?
15. Kierra, what did you get?
I got a 15.
You're basically the only one who notices, I think.
Kierra, you once you guys have sat down and you know, got comfortable and everything, you only notice that Boz isn't there because when Maz comes up with your drinks, you look up and you notice there isn't a tall robot near any of you.
Where's Boz?
I could have sworn he came up with us.
No, I remember he came with us. Where did he go?
At this point, this scene was animated. There'd be a dotted outline of Boz next to you that just blinks in and out like, he should be here.
Well, that droid type is apparently built for stealth and infiltration. And he apparently infiltrated his way away from us.
Oh. Sure, he didn't go too far.
Meanwhile, in Aruba.
I have a feeling he has lots of things up his sleeve. I'm sure he's fine.
He doesn't have sleeves, Kierra. He's a droid.
Before she can slap you for that smart-ass remark, Maz arrives with your drinks.
Japan's
a pure snake. Oh, right, he is heavy. I forgot he is Boz would be a heavy droid. Fuck, I forgot about that.
Yeah, because the arm.
Not only that, but...
arm.
Yeah.
It's just a different alloy as well.
That too. Once she has distributed the drinks to those who wished for them, she sits down with you and looks directly at Kierra, Klorgu, and Phaisa and goes, so what was with the panicking?
I've just never seen this place so quiet.
That's fair, yeah. It's not often. Then again, after a run with Imperials, people tend to just want to sleep it off.
That's fair.
That is fair.
That's all that's happened. Just a wave of exhaustion.
Yeah, everyone, it wasn't just you guys fighting. Some of the other patrons were fighting too.
Maz, I have to ask. Did everyone fall asleep simultaneously, or did they all fall asleep just gradually?
I normally don't track my patients, my tenants' sleeping habits, but I would say gradually.
You can understand why I'd be a little bit suspicious when we come into an establishment and every living soul in there is asleep.
It is late here, and you gotta remember, a lot of these people, they come here to rest.
You left the door open, though.
Gestures to the weather and goes, do you have any idea how hot it gets in that building with all those bodies?
She has a point.
Yeah, she has a point there.
Also, she, like, again, gestures to the open air. It's a beautiful night.
That is true.
Not wrong.
Looks around. Where's your robot friend?
That is an excellent question.
Great question. Deserves an answer. Answer is, we're not sure.
Is Boz going to try his return to them quickly, or is he taking his dear sweet time?
I he'll go quickly, I guess.
Okay, so it's not a, like, you're going to be gone long. Okay.
Absolutely no attempt to stealth on the way back.
Okay. No, because that actually makes things easier. As you guys say that, you hear the clanking of metal on the stairs, and turn to see Boz just, you know, strolling up as if no big deal.
Ah, there he is.
You get the android and he appears.
Where did you go?
It's very warm in here, and I have not dusted internal fan number 3 in a very long time.
Understandable.
My computer's groaned out mood.
It's okay, baby. It's okay. I don't think Holger would like roll inside on that.
Okay.
No, generally, I don't think Klorgu would find any deception in that, so he wouldn't roll insight.
Oh, okay. Okay, no, yeah. Boz will, after Boz rejoins, just take a minute and then go, you seemed to want to talk earlier. What was up to you, Klorgu?
Two things, really. Well, it's a lot of things. Okay, first of all, that muscle bound, whatever he was, and that Twi'lek, something was really off about them.
Oh.
And I have this thing. I'm sure you know, I have this thing, I can kind of tell whether people are off or not, and I can, for lack of a better term, sense stuff accidentally.
And what did you sense?
Well, I'm still practicing. I thought I was sensing them, but it turns out I sensed you. However, they just gave me a really bad vibe.
I can tell you about the Twi'lek. My name is Zadvana. Would you like me to spell that for you? Z-H-A-D apostrophe V-E-N-A.
Mercenaries?
In a way.
Hmm.
They don't work for money. They work for trinkets.
What kind of trinkets? Because we found some ourselves.
Yes, while I was getting your drinks, Emmy informed me of what you found. He's currently going through all of it. She found a lot while she was out there, so she's going to compile it all onto a better source than her own internal computers. But those two deal in, we'll say, darker antiquities.
Hmm.
The masked one, you shouldn't worry about. He's on the path of a zealot. He could come out of it, though. It's too soon to tell. The one he travels with, the Twi'lek, she's committed. She has seen too much, been through too much. She is no longer staring at the abyss. She has jumped into it.
Are they any danger to us?
Only if you get in their way.
Was that them that left but a while ago?
Yes. They didn't get what they wanted from me, so they decided to go elsewhere and see if I changed my mind. You actually did me a favor by doing what you did, though.
Mm.
They were looking.
Not white.
What they were looking for is what Emmy was able to acquire.
That weird temple that we found?
That temple was the ruins of a Jedi outpost from thousands of years ago.
Why would a ruined Jedi outpost have manic inscriptions in various languages about something of an infinite empire?
I can't say. The temple's older than I am. The castle that you're in now, it was built after a bloody history between those two factions of the Force. Emmy hopefully will be able to compile everything so I can get a better picture, but it seems this place was a staging ground at one point for a much larger war. Those two that you saw, they're chasing ghosts, hoping they could find something of it.
Fabulous.
What was the war between the Jedi and the Sith about?
What are any wars about? The Sith wish for power. The Jedi wish to protect people. People get in the way. So the Sith try to kill those in the way. Many would argue once that the Jedi were complacent and let the Sith get to the point that they were due to their more passive ways. They'll stare at you and Phaisa and be like, your people would know. Your people waged a war that nearly conquered the galaxy. Jedi did nothing for a long time. It wasn't until a splinter group in the Jedi came and engaged your people. Pushed you back to the deep reaches of Malachor.
I wasn't told much about the Jedi.
Not many people do know of it anymore.
Mother never mentioned them to me.
The Empire made the Jedi taboo. Looks to Boz. He would know quite a bit about them, I think. Isn't that right, my mechanical friend?
Maybe too much.
See many of them during the war, I assume?
A dozen or so.
About right. There was 10,000 back then.
My uncle said he knew one of them.
Hondo knew quite a few Jedi. One in particular. They were close. I swear
you. Close, like actually close as friends or in Hondo's point of view?
A little bit of both. You'd swear Hondo was in love with the man. Not in the way you think, but that Jedi, he inspired a side of Hondo not many of us saw.
Must have been quite a Jedi to do something like that.
He was. Fortunate that wherever that Jedi went, tragedy followed.
Tragedy followed.
Yeah, many died.
I've heard that before.
Where'd you hear that?
believe it was Hondo. Let me look back at my notes.
Kierra suddenly just checks out.
Kira's having an epiphany right now.
Suddenly you see like Matrix code flying up the visor of Kira's helmet.
She pulls up a data pad and is like searching through the log.
Hold up.
It's in the script right here, page 33. When I fucked up the box.
You got a page 66, that's too far.
Don't go to 66.
Exit stage left, pursued by bear shit. Wrong fucking book.
Looks at Klorgu. What was the other thing you wanted to know? While Kierra researches her memories.
Yes.
I'll pull out the crystal.
Nice what gem. Takes it, looks at it. I'd say 4,000 credits.
No, what I meant.
The crystal.
It changed color.
Oh yeah, it is, isn't it? Puts it up towards the moon so she can get a better look at the light. Which color was it to start?
Purple.
Hmm.
Which reminds me. You have a purple flag that's in tatters.
I do.
Any reason why it's in tatters?
If factions don't come by to upkeep their stuff, I have anything to replace them with. Age does affect everything.
Damn, a question.
Player, an answer.
Was this the faction that I kind of fucked over, or was it the faction I was a part of?
Column B.
Brilliant. Love it.
Don't you?
I love it when my own faction gets fucked over by Miles.
It's not so much fucked over, they just haven't been there, so they couldn't give her anything to update the...
When was the last time you saw them?
She hands you back the crystal and thinks. Decade, maybe? Once you reach my age, time is different. It's not days anymore. It's years or months. Do you know the flag?
Phaisa is staring directly at Klorgu now. Because she is interested to hear this.
She never takes off her helmet, but the teacup is in her hand, like, go on.
Go on.
She's got a sippy straw going under the helmet.
What did you roll? Gotta finish that drink to talk.
Yep. That was the flag of my faction back on Nar Shaddaa before I left.
Then you having the crystal makes sense.
I'm guessing it's a member's insignia.
It's... The higher-ups had them. That's how they got in and out of places.
Wait. Didn't that guy on Ratatak give that to you?
Nope. No, the mother gave it to me.
Oh yeah, she did. Why would the mother of a Nightsister colony have something like that if it belongs to your faction?
Maz takes a long sip of her drink while you guys are discussing, is like, gives that, indeed, why would she? Like, expression on her face. Also, did you find what you're looking for in your notes?
Yes.
Okay.
I did. It was Hondo. Who
okay.
Said something very similar.
Okay. While you two muse over that, she looks to Shez. I noticed earlier you were interested in the band.
Well, I suppose interested is a word you could use.
Music type?
Yes.
No, come. Be true to yourself here. Remember, as long as I have lived, you start seeing the repeats in other people.
You start seeing the same people. Oh god, the same eyes.
Different people. Gorgeous. Talk to Auntie Miles.
Well, I don't focus on it as much as I do fighting, but I do love music.
I can tell. She grabs your hand and starts looking at it.
What?
She starts tracing the lines on your hand, like the palm. Like, see, your hand's still very soft. A fighter, at heart, these would be rougher. There'd be calluses, there'd be scars, there'd be signs that you prefer to use these to take life. But notice you don't have those.
Are you criticizing my abilities?
No, I'm reminding you that while you do fight when you need to, your heart is more of a creative side. You should embody that.
It's never been a Nightsister skill. It was usually just fighting and magic. At least my colony focused on that.
She leans in really quietly. When I grew up, women weren't really in charge of pirates. Then you meet me. The hell with what people say for rules. Think of them as more like guidelines.
Yes!
Oh, yes.
I swear to God, yes. She is alien Barbossa.
I am so happy right now.
But tell me, does it make you happy when you do stuff like that?
Very much so, yeah.
And pursue it.
I don't know how. My focus has never been on anything creative, and I've always trained. I don't even know where I'd start.
Maz, like, looks to the others and has a moment before, trying to not presume, but the you I'm looking at isn't the you were born as, am I right?
Yes.
To get where you are, that was the first creative thing you've ever done.
Oh my god, I'm gonna cry.
Start there. No.
And that's where the facts.
You go, you find that place, you'll find what you look for. That, or just go to a bunch of concerts, take notes.
I used to do that as much as I could. Growing up, whenever I would, anyone would be in town, I'd listen to as much music as I could before my sisters would drag me away.
I assume with this group, they wouldn't be adverse to you taking stops to enjoy some music.
No?
Well, R&R is not unwanted.
Looks over to Boz. I feel like that one actually knows a lot of music somehow. He seems to have gotten around. He's probably seen some things.
Yeah.
Meanwhile, Boz is like, shit, she knows my music collection.
Maybe. Well, maybe if we spot the concert or performer, Maybe we'll catch some tickets.
If you guys come back at some point, I'll ask you about it again. I want to hopefully hear something you've come up with.
Oh.
I want to be for everyone down there, just for me.
I would be more comfortable with that. Yeah.
Klorgu laying in the sheds. You are getting a private given a private concert to the Pirate Queen.
This is a pretty big thing.
Maz throws her little cup at you. Don't pressure her. By the way, you took one HP of damage. Because it was point blank to the face.
To be fair, something tells me she never throws anything lightly. It's always
it is full. Listen. Yeah, it is full force. And also, it was point blank.
In her seat, going.
Look, I can imagine the sound as well. Just. It was
you
aggressive.
Okay?
It was aggressive encouragement. What can I say?
You can learn to say nothing.
Oh, that's the truth. Okay. Other people, they should learn to do that.
Where are you all heading after this?
I believe we're going
Tatooine, yes.
Yeah. Mm. I was just to follow the hyperspace lane there.
That's a good idea. I'll have some of my people refuel that ship of his.
It's my ship now.
Better in your hand than his.
I'm the one who picked it out, so.
So you have good taste.
My mom raised me well. I noticed her flag was hanging outside too. How long ago was that hung up?
Maz, because of where you guys are sitting, she can look up and see the flags. Which one's your mother's?
And Phaisa will point to the crate dragon flag that's next to Anakin Skywalker's.
Ah, yes. Crate dragon. That's your mother, huh?
Yeah. She's an alias, so people wouldn't know she was a woman in the pod races. Let alone a human.
Hmm. That one was a wild one. I want to say, judging based on the shape of the flag, judging based on how you sound, I would say that was... Ten, 12 years ago.
She was still racing around then, I think.
It was a good race. She really made that Doug just eat dust. Then again, after Skywalker beat him, never been the same.
His mother sounds like a hoot.
Can't imagine how Sebulba felt losing to a human twice.
Well,
my mom, it's not very common for humans to pod race.
Only two.
At that point, Klorgu will actually turn to Phaisa. Wait. Sebulba? Your mom won the Bunta Eve?
Yeah.
And Paige is gonna do some quick calculation real quick. You said, how many years ago?
10 or 12.
10 or 12, because Phaisa is 20. I'll say 12.
Yeah, I was 8 when she won that race. It was one of her last circuits before she retired. Her biggest dream was to win the Bunta Eve. That's how she got her 5th stripe on the flag. Each of those stripes is a win for a race. That's why I have 5 stripes on my helmet.
Oh. Wait, so all of those flags are from pod racers?
No. Some of them are from pod racers. Some were from factions, like Klorgu mentioned. Maz could probably explain more than I can.
Factions, pods, affiliations, anyone who stopped by here and has a good story to bring with them.
Oh. Okay.
Shir Hondo must have stopped by after the race.
Actually, it was just your mother and another man.
Who?
Can't remember. You gotta remember how many people I get in a day. All I remember is he was very serious.
Very serious man with mom. That's weird. My mom usually didn't travel with other people besides Hondo.
Now, this one... Well, if you don't know, it's probably nothing. Because your mother would have told you.
I'm sorry, I heard the Haunted Mansion music.
Even I was like, wait, what the fuck?
Maz has a Disney soundtrack for After Hours.
it helps her clean.
Oh my goodness.
I guess you got a point.
I'll be back.
Yeah.
No worries, hon.
I guess you got a point there. If there's something I didn't need to know, she didn't tell me.
Hmm. Tatooine. You know what part of Tatooine you'll be going to?
I'm not sure.
I'm familiar with Mos Eisley. I've been there as a kid and with one of my covert members when he did one of his bounty jobs.
Alright.
They're kicked out of Cantina there, though.
There is quite a few cantinas on Tatooine.
That's true. And I managed to get kicked out of one of them.
I just don't know what the hell I'm supposed to be searching for.
The glowy cube told you just to go to Tatooine?
Yeah.
Glowing cube, you say?
You done it now.
Yeah. There's this cube box thing. I tried to open it multiple times, but it wasn't working until it finally did. And, it's gonna sound crazy, but this voice came out. A Qui-Gon Jinn, and he told me that something about my lineage, that I don't know my lineage, I don't know where I come from. I was just raised by my great aunt. So he told me to go to a planet with two suns to find answers on where exactly I came from. And why I'm able to do such weird things.
Maz finishes her listening to you and just sits there pensively. I don't know any Qui-Gon Jinn. Sounds very handsome. Sounds like a man with an accent.
Well, you're not wrong.
But I do hope you find what you're looking for on Tatooine. It's normally not a place you would find what you seek, but you're sent there. Hopefully you do find what you're looking for.
I hope so too.
Now perhaps you'll hear his voice again when we reach the planet's surface.
That's a possibility.
Let's just try not to get lost in the dune sea.
At the dune sea, you've gone too far.
At this point, Emmy arrives in the doorway near you guys, into the castle itself, and kind of curtly gets Maz's attention, saying that she is needed. So Maz gets up and goes, "You can stay the night if you wish, but if you don't want to, that's fine as well. My rule here is first nights are always free. Any more, you must pay. If you don't stay the night, the free night will be whenever you do come back." If you do wind up hitting up Mos Eisley, she reaches into her outfit and pulls out a data pad and hands it off to Kierra. use this to land, and that way you'll be actually allowed to. I don't go there often as much, so might as well let it be used while someone is going there.
You lagged really bad for me. What did she pull out from her pocket?
A data pad that'll get you guys access to land in Mos Eisley.
Thank you.
Yeah, sorry.
Landing codes.
Yeah, just hold on to that, Kierra. I'll be able to land the ship. You just guide me through whatever the data pad gives you.
She, before going inside, stops. Says something to Emmy just quietly that you guys can't hear. Turns to Boz and goes, "You would draw attention where you're going. Might I suggest something?" And Emmy returns and hands Boz a lovely hooded poncho. Tatooine is full of sand. It's extremely hot, and I imagine you would fare well to be protecting your parts.
Just gonna take it and not say anything.
Is that a reluctant thank you?
No, it's him contemplating where he can get a sombrero now.
I mean, Phaisa did draw a mustache on him, so...
Yeah, he still has a mustache and a monocle on his face. And he technically has Heelys welded to his feet.
My god. What is...
Boz just needs a serape.
Yeah. I think it's like a bonus action to like activate the Heelys.
Yeah, I think it's a bonus action just to like kick them in on. Moss smiles at you and just goes, "You don't have to return that. It's been here for a while. Hopefully you wouldn't get use out of it."
Should we wash it before he uses it?
I think it'll be fine.
I do clean up anything left behind. It has been cleaned.
Plus, even if it was dirty, we're going to be going to Tatooine. There's no point in washing it.
Really?
You get dirty once you step on planet.
The desert planet.
Oh, then that makes sense.
Dan and I were sleeping sand out of the Razor Crest for at least a week.
With that, Moz does return inside and goes downstairs, leaving out the option. Do you guys wish to stay the night, or do you guys want to hit the ship and leave right away?
If we stay the night, Phaisa will spend the night on the Mythosaur. She's okay. Gonna save that free day.
Okay.
I say we save the free day.
So just pack up and leave.
We can spend the night on the ship, or we can pack up, jump to hyperspace, and then it'll take us a while to get to Tatooine. So we could probably have a rest on the jump.
Yeah,
we can do a jump rest.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, with that being said, you guys all will start to head back to the Mythosaur. As you leave, Maz says her goodbyes, and Emmy thanks you all for assisting her in her adventure.
Try not to get stuck in another cave again.
I shall try. But if I do, I hope you guys will find me again.
Also, it's probably best to tell Mars where you're going if you're going to go on a little walk.
That ruins the fun. Yeah. If she knows where I am, I'm not really alone, am I?
Yes, she is.
Is Morrison okay now?
Morrison's actually asleep in your arms.
Oh, the baby!
Are we bringing the chicken with us?
Does the party want to bring the chicken?
There's no question about it!
I'm wondering, because how many empty rooms do we have left on the Mythosaur?
I feel like if you guys brought it, Shez was going to be like, no, the chicken stays with me at all times.
I mean, Morrison can eventually have his own room, too.
That's fair.
Oh my god, that would be so cute.
No, that's why I asked how many rooms, how many unoccupied rooms do we have left? Because we all know Hondo's is off limits whenever he visits.
Yeah, hold on. I'm actually going to look how many rooms are on it. Star Wars.
I was going to say, it's a pretty big yacht. It's got to be.
It's a big yacht.
It's going to be more than five.
Yeah.
It is. Let's see. It allows for.
Luxury 3000. It's a nice yacht.
Hmm.
I'm gonna need to install guns on it though.
You'll be here and I'd be on a yacht. Ah!
It can hold 10 including the crew, can hold 10 passengers.
Nice. So 10 rooms maybe?
Yeah, on it? There are 10 rooms.
Okay. All right. Okay. So if we ever want to upgrade Morrison's lodgings, he could probably have a room to himself.
Fun fact.
I love that.
There's actually a meditation pool on the yacht.
We have a jacuzzi?
Meditation
we adopt
pool.
A duck.
We got a jacuzzi. What you're telling me is we have a space jacuzzi.
Yes, I'm telling you that on this yacht, emphasizing the word yacht, there is a jacuzzi.
I am just picturing the whole party in there, and Phaisa still has a helmet, just like...
Oh, yeah. Two bros chilling in a hot
tub.
5 feet apart, that's gay.
But yeah, are you guys gonna leave right away? You said, and just rest on the jump.
Yeah,
okay.
We'll rest on the jump.
Whenever
Phaisa like jumps to hyperspeed or whatever, Kierra wants to like sit with her and talk with her.
Okay, well,
I'll be in the cockpit just calculating the jump once we're out of the atmosphere.
That being said, I want to see how far. Yeah. One.
We're going to have to take a couple turns at some planets.
There are going to be five like detours to make along the way.
Mm-hmm.
So either you can all have one shift by yourselves, or someone's going to have two watches. Just in the cockpit to make sure stuff is, you know, on track.
Mm-hmm. Well, I'm the pilot, so I'll take the two watches.
Okay, so who wants to take first with Phaisa on the first watch? Okay, Kierra. Second watch, who will be... Okay, Shez. Klorgu or Boz for third?
Klorgu will take third, unless Boz, if you have anything that you want to do on the third.
Well, Boz can
sleep. I don't need to sleep.
Yeah, so the watch is where he will do something other than whatever he wants to do on his own.
Mm-hmm.
That is fair. In which case, Klorgu will take third anyway.
Okay, Boz will take fourth.
And then Phaisa will be back for the fifth one.
Okay.
As we're approaching the planet, hopefully.
And if anyone wants, they can stay up with Phaisa for the fifth.
Yeah.
We will do the watches though after a quick break.
Yeah.
So everyone can get up, stretch, go to the bathroom, get some water or whatever they need to do. Me particularly, I need more water. The BRBs.
And add. What?
No, I was gonna ask Kitsune something, but I'll ask him when he gets back, because I want to know the name of my faction.
I want to know who this mysterious man was with my mother.
I think we all know.
I don't think it's who we think it is.
A serious man.
Lando serious. My mom has met Lando Calrissian, and he is serious.
Oh,
he's charming. But he's charming.
He's charming, but he can be serious too.
Mars would have remembered Lando.
That's so true. But honestly, I have no fucking clue, because by my calculations, she and my dad have not talked even before I was born. Unless Katsune's planning something. I don't know. I'm gonna go get water.
Okay. Have we been referred to as the Misfits at all? Have we referred to ourselves as the Misfits? Has other people called us the Misfits yet?
I think that was our...
It was our placeholder name.
I honestly think, like, That was our call sign for when we did do the Rebel Alliance job.
I think. Okay, because when y'all were talking about, like, the flags, and then I was like, hang on, is it strictly for pod racers? But it's, like, generally. So now my goal is to get us a flag so that we can put it up there one day.
Yes.
Oh, I have an idea.
Oh?
I love how Hannah just kind of shifts in.
So, this is just the main body of it. Five stripes of different color. Green, light blue, gray, red.
Black, maybe?
Black, I would say. And possibly some other design in there as well.
Some kind of like circle design in the middle.
Mm.
It'd be kind of fun.
Wait. Holding.
Oh boy.
She's gonna start drawing this shit.
Oh boy. Hang on.
I'm gonna get Cheez-Its.
I
kind of already have a design in my head.
What is this flag list?
We're thinking about making our own flag for the Misfits.
Okay.
Yeah.
Also, Kitsune, with the name of the faction, something simple. The purple set.
Okay. Keep it written down.
I will message it to you.
I meant for your own notes.
Oh, yeah, no, oh, I'll be updating my character sheet.
Yeah.
We're all like conspiracy theory and wondering who this mystery man was.
Which mystery man?
Could have been who?
Could have been Jin. Jindara.
Jindara?
No, my mom doesn't know Den. I'm the only one who knows Den.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Yeah.
Yeah, because my mom supposedly died during the purge. That's around zero. That's around the Battle of Yavin that happened. Mm-hmm. And Phaisa was 14. Mm-hmm. She planet hopped until she got stuck on Navarro. And Din found her half dead in the sewers.
Always the sewers.
He was kind of impressed that she got down there.
I don't like that, but with the different colors.
See, I like.
Mine were my idea.
The pee really was... bad.
Alright.
But yes, absolutely show it.
My idea was more on the lines of. Eh.
While you do that, I'm thinking, based on everyone's exhaustion and everything, maybe another hour, 20 minutes, hour and a half.
Yeah.
I'm good with that.
If everyone can do that, then I think I can stretch that as the goal for what I got notes wise.
Yeah. I don't know about y'all, but I'm fucking awake now.
I'm awake now, actually.
Like, you need sleep, sir.
I was fading. Well, no, I was fading. Like, here's the thing I hate about late night D&D. The waiting for it is just. But once you're in it, your mind's awake, you're talking to people, it's keeping you awake, and I'm just like, okay.
Okay. But still, if everyone can do about an hour and a half, cool. If we have to go, if we at the end sooner, that's fine.
Mm-hmm.
I'm good with that.
Okay. I was mostly taking into account because I know Alice has the schools tomorrow, and damn if she will not be staying up late for that.
Mm-hmm.
Especially if it's that much musical shit. Fuck.
Where is it? I have the alphabet here. Ah! I need to drop my vape.
I'm just gonna throw it.
It's surprisingly top heavy.
It's the funniest thing. Like, vapes were only just like becoming like a thing, I guess, when I was in high school.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Thinking back to how old you are, yeah, I keep forgetting that you're like, that was the beginning. Period of vaping.
That's how old I am.
like when I was in college, like the vape pens and the vaporizers that looked like cigarettes were coming out and everything, and I went onto those when I tried to quit smoking.
Were they called Juuls?
No, Juuls way after, man.
Really?
Yeah, Juuls weren't until like 2016.
You're right. Okay.
They weren't ever called vaporizers. They were just they weren't ever called vapes. They were just called e-cigarettes.
E-cigs, okay.
I remember now.
I remember those.
I actually almost got one of the original ones because I thought it would help me stop biting my nails.
Yeah.
But then everyone's like, no, you actually can still get the stuff in your lungs if you do it too much. I'm like, never mind.
Yeah. I had a couple pens in college, and yeah, the nicotine addiction got bad for me, and I had to wean off nicotine. And then I just stopped using them after the nicotine was gone.
That makes sense.
Yeah.
And then after that, I imagine all the douchebags started using them, so you're like, oh, thank God I stopped.
Yeah. It was nice getting just like the flavors and stuff. Yeah. My favorite, back when I still had the nicotine in it, my favorite was raspberry lemon. This was when Pokemon Go came out. So the shop I went to did Pokemon themed juices. And raspberries were in Pokemon Go, so they made a flavor called raspberry lemon.
Speaking of Pokemon, the person who does heartless Pokemon mashups, did slack off.
Aww,
so cute.
Oh, what did you wind up naming the Empyreon you got the other day, Daisy?
The what?
The penguin you caught. What did you wind up naming it?
Oh, Meg suggested that I name my Empoleon Two Toes Joe.
That was it, okay.
So my Empoleon in Pokemon Go is named Two Toes Joe.
Aww.
What was your the metal boy?
Oh, my big Aggron. His name is George.
Oh god, I'm pulling up Pokemon Go now to see what I remember that I gotta remember what I named my Snorlax.
I have not played Pokemon Go since 2019. Yeah, 2019.
I haven't played it in a long ass time.
I'm afraid if I open it's going
to
be like...
3 months ago, I actually got a phone that was able to run a game, so this is all a very new experience to me.
For the record, I always loved seeing his updates when he'd be like, guys, I walked to the nearest gym and I'm fucking keeping this gym.
Oh my god, there's a Pikachu next to me.
Get it.
I'm going to try to. There's like, holy shit, like, so many Pokemon near me. No, I got a Spoink instead. No, I don't want to fight you. I'm running away.
Really?
I want the Pikachu.
Because
okay.
Of quarantine, you no longer actually have to move for spawn rates to exist. So,
I will say I kind of prefer that because even when people like before quarantine, a lot of people did complain about that.
Let me give you a raspberry. Now obey. Get in the ball.
The person
you
also
asshole.
The person did Mimikyu. Paige.
Ah, Mimikyu! So cute.
Anna.
I caught the Sparky boy.
Yes. Sparky boom boy.
Sparky boom boy.
Where the fuck are you? I know you're here.
Okay.
Okay, what the fuck did I name my Snorlax?
Good question. Alice, I brought up to everyone else. I'm letting you because you have to get up in the morning. Would you say an hour and a half is a good amount for you? Muted.
Say that again.
Would you say about an hour and a half would be good for you to say would be not late?
Yes.
Okay. Because we don't want to keep you up too late.
Well, I mean, if I feel like dying, then
school
I'll
first.
Like, clock out. But
school first.
Of course, I named my Snorlax this.
Yeah.
It was the first one I ever caught.
Hold on.
I caught this fucker.
What is his what's his size stats?
He is 2.49 meters.
So that's
607.52 kilograms. He is extra large.
Hold on. 2.9 you said for height?
Yeah, 2.49.
That would
meters.
Be 6'5" or so?
6'5".
And weight
he's around 607 kilograms.
Okay. Okay, for those who actually use real numbers,
feel when you're only an inch shorter than Snorlax? Question mark.
I need help. 600 and what kilograms?
607 kilograms.
607 kilograms, pounds. 1,338 pounds.
Jesus.
My penis, dummy thick.
All I'm gonna say, that's a snuggle buddy.
Clip that. Hold on.
That's a snuggle buddy.
Daisy's like, quick, my people need me.
I have to go clip that. That has to be clipped.
So, this is my idea for the Outer Rim Misfits flag.
Oh.
Ooh.
And
cool.
The
Arabesh.
The Arabesh.
I love that.
Acronym.
Form.
Yeah.
Me and my friend Danny were saying we love how the acronym is Aquaman's psychotic evil brother.
Orm.
The end goal is for you guys to just conquer Atlantis. Well, space Atlantis.
As long as Amber Heard isn't in the picture.
Fuck that. But Hannah.
Yeah.
What we could do is combine ideas, because I love that little symbol you did.
Yeah. I thought it was kind of cool with like a
plane. I didn't see it.
Gun behind it or
I
something.
Didn't see it. Show me.
What is? All
right.
Oh, period.
So each stripe is a different color for each of our characters.
And then two suns?
Yeah. Well, not exactly two suns, but it's like, I don't know. Planets, suns, stars, I don't know.
It's a design.
The clip is there.
Oh, God.
It is in the general chat for the Discord.
So, could you send me a picture of what you did, and I can formulate?
Yes.
Okay. I've got to watch this now.
You gotta laugh at your own penis joke?
Yes.
My time has come.
Make that a ringtone.
Oh.
I'd say that's a better clip than my paint joke.
That was good. Oh, I need a life.
You have one.
Mm-hmm.
Second one with a second wife and children. In New Mexico.
In New Mexico.
One's a coyote. I mean, the wife's a coyote. Helps bring people across the border.
Mm-hmm.
The daughters are learning 5 different languages to help pay for, things by doing translating jobs.
Mm. Alright, so we're going on a trip in our favorite rocket ship.
Going to explore.
Zooming through the skies.
Nice little lines.
We're gonna fucking die.
Bye.
Alright, so the first shift is going to be the Kira and the Phaisa. Now that we are all situated in back. So the three of you who are not on shift at the moment, consider this your long rest point, because it's going to be a long trip. Not that you need it, but just if you wanted to do it, here's your chance.
Hmm.
For those of you who are on shift, have your shift begin now.
Kira's gonna go into the cockpit and sit next to Phasia and just look out at the stars and all that. And just go. So
we're technically in hyperspace, so you're just seeing streaks of blue.
Yeah, yep. So, you talked a bit about your mom.
Yeah. She basically, she was a podraiser out here in the Outer Rim.
Do you remember that at all?
Of course. She raised me by herself on Mandalore. She knew Hondo before I was born. And whenever we weren't on tour for her races, we would do jobs with him. He helped teach me how to fly. And yeah, everything was going great. Till the purge.
Mm-hmm.
I was 14. Empire was trying to conquer Mandalore again. I think your great aunt was fighting against them. All I remember that day is bombs falling from the sky, stormtroopers raiding everyone's homes. My mom and I tried to escape and get on a ship that was leaving. We got separated in the crowd. I managed to get off planet. And all I saw was my town burning.
I'm sorry.
It was years ago. There's nothing for you to apologize about for.
From what I heard, your mother sounded like a lot of fun.
Yeah. Second human to win the Prince of Eve. It's rare for humans to even pod race.
Yeah, I haven't heard of many humans pod racing.
According to other species, humans don't have the fast reflexes for it. My mom, she was something different. She's a good racer, good pilot, pretty good mechanic as well.
Really?
Yeah. Every time Hondo brought in a busted up ship, she was able to fix it.
Resourceful.
Yeah. Well, she grew up alone on Mandalore. She lost her parents during the Clone Wars. I think that's when, I don't know, I think it was probably when Death Watch took over for a bit. So your aunt is Bo-Katan Kryze, what I heard.
Yeah! Yeah, she's quite something. Stern, but she cares. She's strong, very headstrong, and opinionated. She taught me everything I know. She taught me how to be a Mandalorian, even though Mandalore isn't exactly how it used to be. But she did her best, I think. Although I've given her some trouble from time to time. But I think she does her best. I think she's done her best to raise me. Even though I give her hell.
You think she's wondering where you are right now?
Maybe. Probably. Yeah, probably, yeah. But I never really had roots to grow anywhere. We were always bouncing from place to place. Why exactly, I'm not quite sure. She just said because it's safe, but I know she's my great aunt, but I don't know much about my family. Every time I ask, she changes the subject.
Question for the DM.
Answer for the player.
Would I know anything about the Kryze clan? Would my mom have taught me anything about them?
Roll a history. Well, lore.
Roll a lore check.
I always want to say history check. Damn, 5e.
Average 11.
Your mother taught you about Satine, about how during the Clone Wars, the Duchess was a pacifist. She tried to keep Mandalore out of the war. She fought corruption on the planet. And how, after her death, her sister, Bo-Katan, really took it hard and fought tooth and nail to avenge her sister. You don't know much beyond the common history of the family, as you guys weren't exactly part of the high society that would deal with it.
Yeah.
What I remember from what my mom taught me, your aunt's sister, the Duchess, apparently she was a pretty strong woman. She tried to keep peace on Mandalore. If anything, at least you have a positive legacy to keep. Those strong leaders.
Yeah.
Just a legacy to protect.
Aaron Burr, get out of my head. Okay, I'm good.
God damn it, I forgot what I was gonna say.
My bad.
You're good. Shoot, what was it?
Had a positive legacy. What?
Positive legacy,
right.
Great, strong leaders.
Right. She'll just say, yeah, I suppose there was a bit of a strong legacy there. At the same time, I'm kind of worried with the other part of my family. There's this gaping hole in my family tree that I have no idea is going on there. I don't know if it's a dark past, if it's insignificant, if it's extremely significant. I have no idea. And it's already hard enough with Bo-Katan's expectations of me. She expects a lot from me, but it's always for the best.
Maybe the best thing you can do is carve a path of your own.
I suppose that's true. I am honored to be a Kryze.
Good thing to still have family around.
Yeah. But it's nice to know your mother.
Not sure she would approve of my choices, lifestyle I live now, but now that I know she's gone, I had to do what I had to do to survive.
Survival is survival.
This is the way.
This is the way.
Was there anything else you two want to do while on your watch, or are you guys just going to hang out in the cockpit?
Hang out in the cockpit. Just keep an eye on the charts and stuff.
Okay.
Keep an eye on the sensors.
Make sure everything's in order.
Okay. Just figured I'd make sure before I swap ships. Was there anything else you two wanted to cover? Or was it just a casual conversation the whole shift?
Yeah.
Okay.
Just talking about moms and aunts and stuff.
Yeah.
My family.
Since, unlocking each other's backstory.
Yes.
Since we know that Boz doesn't sleep, what is he doing while they're on their first shift?
Up until his own shift, Boz is committing acts of vandalism that we have talked about.
Okay.
What?
Let's just say during everyone's watches, you hear a power saw and an acetylene torch.
Boz, you better not be wrecking my ship.
The worst part is, I know it now. I remember what he's mentioned.
I swear to the stars, if he destroys the ship, I'm gonna use his head for target practice.
For what it's worth, it's fine.
It's not fine if I don't know what it is.
He's just an assassin droid with a acetylene torch and a buzzsaw. Don't worry about it.
I'm even more concerned. Okay, after my shift, I go to my room. I lock the door. I take my helmet off and I sleep.
Okay. Kira, are you going to do anything before you head to bed?
Probably, like she'll probably just look at the holocron on the box. Not try to open it or anything. Just mull it over. And then go to sleep.
Okay. Second shift, I believe that is Shez.
Yeah.
What would you like to do during your shift? Anything specific?
Feed Morrison.
Okay, you can feed Morrison. Since you're on the ship now, you can actually go to the kitchen and get actual food.
Ooh, do we have any little berries that he might like?
Roll up investigation. Let's see if Hondo has any berries.
I would hope Hondo keep the fridge stocked.
Okay, you guys got a month of supplies. Let's see if he actually has berries. Let's see if we can give Morrison some bougie food.
I want him to be a king. Oh, 16.
You open the fridge and. Surprising to everyone, I would imagine, there is actually a fridge full of produce. Like, there's actual greens on this ship.
Hondo wants Phaisa to eat her veggies.
You find an assortment of berries, assortment of vegetables, fruits. I'll even find some, what looks to be recently made cheeses and all that such.
Wow, okay.
As a small halfling eats herself into the cheese.
I'm gonna like sort of pick up Morrison and like let him have a look at what's in the fridge, and if there's anything that he particularly likes, then he can like poke at it, and then I would give him the snack.
Okay, so you guys have to make a fruit salad for the two of you.
Probably, yeah. Okay. A little snack.
Do you want to find anything else for you while you're at it, or is that going to be good?
Wait, anything to eat?
Just anything. Like, you just look in the fridge. Do you want to look for anything else, or are you just good with what you have?
I'm pretty okay with what I have. I might go, like, after Morrison has a snack, I might ask Phaisa if she wants a snack. Or no, I'm up. She's gone.
Yeah, you're the only one awake right now.
I'm here.
That reminds me. Roll a perception to see if you notice the sound of a buzzsaw and acetylene torch.
Okay.
Do you hear Boz working in his room?
Perception?
Yes, please.
Oh, that's a 6.
You don't hear anything. You're busy with Morrison. You don't hear anything.
Morrison, eat your food. Actually, I'm going to check if there's any more of those, like, seaweed snacks I found a long time ago, maybe hidden away somewhere.
Okay, you said you rolled a 16 originally?
Yes.
Okay. You find another bag.
Ooh.
This one is, completely sealed, not even touched. So you can munch on that while Morrison has his little fruit salad.
Oh, yes. Yes.
Was there anything else you wished to do on your shift?
My natural response would be make sure everything on the ship is okay, but I don't know if I know anything about this ship or how to run it.
It wouldn't. That would be, in this case, a... I would just have you do an intelligence check.
Okay.
Just to, like, see if anything looks out of place, nothing's on fire, you know.
Yeah.
There's no droid ripping apart the panels and, you know, making a ruckus.
Yeah, that would not... That would not be great. Okay. Wait, I roll for this, yes?
Yes, intelligence.
Yes, intelligence. Oh, it fell off. Hang on.
It's cocked.
Oh. 16.
Okay. You let Morrison stay at the table and munch on his fruit salad while you take the bag of chips and walk around, just do a quick patrolling. You don't see anything wrong. However, at this point, you suddenly hear the noises coming from Boz's quarters.
Can I, like, politely knock on the door?
You can knock, see what happens.
I'm gonna knock.
Does Boz answer the knocking?
Boz comes to the door with, a lit torch in one hand. Like an acetylene torch, not an adventuring torch.
Hi. Is everything okay?
Splendid.
You having fun?
Lots.
Should I ask?
I'm just making the place more homely.
Fun.
Yes.
I was going to offer you if you wanted any snacks, but I'm not sure if you would like these chips.
I appreciate the offer. However.
Oh no, everything froze.
Uh-oh.
Oh, hang on. Oh, hi. Okay, hi.
Hi. Okay.
Okay. I appreciate the offer. However,
Pause.
Oh,
there.
I pressed the wrong button.
Oh, okay.
I have one button for the voice changer, one button that mutes me, and I
muted
myself instead of turning the voice changer off. He takes his free hand and just dinks himself in the face to show that he physically does not have a mouth.
Yes, I realized. That's why I didn't actually ask. Do you need anything?
The support all of you have shown is enough for me. Thank you.
I don't know if that's wholesomeness or sarcasm.
I don't know. I don't know if it's meant to be a softening the blow, whatever Phaisa finds in the morning.
Oh, God.
That's misdirection right there.
Definitely.
Be as nice as he can. Phaisa wakes up. What has happened to my ship?
Okay, well. I'm glad you're enjoying yourself. Don't blast a hole through the ship.
I will try my best. Have a good night.
You too. I'm gonna walk back to the kitchen with Morrison.
What I love the most is I picture it being like in Teen Titans when Raven would open the door just enough for her face. You can't see anything behind. And it's just like, What you doing? Nothing. What do you want? And then when he closes, you see the door slowly close on his own face.
I loved how ever so slightly awkward it was. Casual, but awkward.
But still wholesome.
Yes, yes.
You return to Morrison. Hold on.
Okay.
He's actually curled up on the table, sleeping. He had finished his food.
Oh, I love this chicken. I love this chicken.
The way he's sleeping, his mohawk feathers are doing now an emo thing where it's covering like a part of his face. This chicken has entered his emo phase.
Yeah.
But he will tell you it's not a phase, Mom.
Am I his mother?
I mean, taking care of him, feeding him. I mean, might be.
I'm a bird mom. I am bird mom. This is fantastic. Okay.
Did you wish to do anything else?
Yes, one last thing. That talk with Moz kind of inspired me. So I'm going to take out my little journal. I'm going to try to make something, like a song or maybe choreography.
This is creativity, I would say. It's more because it's for yourself. Is there performance in this one?
There is performance.
Yeah, then roll performance.
I think my performance is actually bad. My performance is fine.
Yeah, because it's based on charisma. Because if there wasn't a performance skill, I was going to be like, just roll charisma. But since you have performance, roll that.
Yeah. God.
Yes.
I stopped it from rolling off the table, and I kind of regret doing so.
I would say if it was going to roll off, we'll call it cocked. You get to fix that. Because you also interfere with the roll by touching it.
That's true. Oh, okay. Okay, didn't touch it, didn't mess with it this time. Yep. 18.
Moz's inspiration served you well. You're not only able to come up with choreography, but you're also able to come up with two verses and a chorus for a song completely original to yourself. You don't know the melody or anything like that, but you got two verses and a chorus down, plus choreography if you sang it.
Oh my god, yes. So yes.
Moz got through to you.
Yes! Thank you, Moz! Because last time this happened, I was distracted by chips.
I mean, to be fair, chips are quite different.
They were amazing. Yeah. Absolutely the best thing in the whole world.
This time the chips gave you just the muse you need.
Oof. Yes. Yes. Period.
We'll say that doing that much of work took up the rest of your watch. And right as you are like about to start another one, you hear Klorgu come up into the mess area and say he's ready for his shift and you can go take a rest.
I haven't eaten all the chips, have I?
Did you want to eat them all?
I wasn't trying to.
Then no, you didn't. You can take them back with you, though.
I'm gonna offer him some, though.
Okay.
Like, these are addictive, but they're good.
I kind of look at them, grab one. We'll try it. They are pretty.
Back from Moncala.
We have.
Do you want the rest of these?
Are you satisfied with your chip intake?
I would say so, yes. And I shouldn't eat all of them anyways. This thing is like spice.
Klorgu's trying so hard not to just yoink the bag out of her hands, isn't he?
Well, I appreciate it, and kindly, yes, I would love to finish off that bag.
Okay, take the rest.
All right.
And I scoop up Morrison, trying not to wake him. The little precious, Morrison. My little Morrison.
One day I'm gonna get you a chicken.
Oh.
A chicken plushie.
Please. I don't have a chicken. I would love a chicken.
Question for the DM. Was anything wrong with my door when I went into my room for my first rest?
I don't know. Let's consult the doorman. Doorman, was there anything wrong with the door?
No, I don't know why no one believes me when I said I just went to learn how the door works.
Okay. And no, nothing is wrong with the door.
Somehow I still don't believe you.
Maybe because you would fuck with the door and you're projecting.
Oh.
Look, I'm not that much of a trickster. Depends who I'm with. Anywho.
So yes, you send off Shez to bed.
Rest well, Shez.
Thanks.
What does Klorgu wish to do on his... Actually, before we do anything, roll perception to see if you hear the noises coming from Boz's quarters. Now that you're awake and can actually hear things.
Oh yeah, I can hear it. I rolled an 18 on the die.
You not only hear, because you hear the sound of the buzzsaw, a few hammers, you actually swear, like, you know it, no one will believe you, but you swear you heard sounds that aren't power tool related.
Logo will knock on the door of Boz's
okay
compartment. Boz.
The door slides open and Boz is there with a hammer in his hand and there's a singe mark going up one side of his face.
Little arts and crafts.
Oh yes, lots of crafts.
And are these arts and crafts going to get you shot by Phaisa?
I certainly don't think so. This will be to everybody's benefit.
I'm rolling an insight check on this motherfucker.
Okay, that means it's insight versus persuasion.
Persuasion.
I don't know why, but I feel like Phaisa just sat up in her sleep going, someone's lying about my ship, and I'm just there.
I said the disturbance of the force.
Not even a fucking force user.
I said the disturbance in the bullshit.
Yeah.
Inside check, that is 17.
And how is the persuasion?
It's a 4 minus 2.
Oh, okay, well, do you believe him? I would say you're able to see through that he is not lying, right?
Yes, not lying, yeah.
So you're able to see through okay. that. So his crypticness does leave a bit to be desired, though you can tell by how he's talking, he's not ready to share. And you can tell he's being very polite, even though he's curious to why everyone's coming to his door and being like, doing?
To be fair, it's very noisy.
I was going to say. I don't mean this to disturb you, Boz. It's just that it's not exactly hard to miss.
No, I'm using construction equipment. It's very loud, and I apologize.
Just make sure that whatever you're doing is not going to get you absolutely chucked up the airlock and just left in the vacuum of space.
That would be unfortunate.
Yeah. Because I know we've only known the whole group as a whole for a short amount of time, but at the same time, I wouldn't put it past Phaisa to think about it twice.
Understandable. But I am convinced this will benefit us as a whole.
Alright. I'll leave you to it.
Have a good night!
As the door closes, Klorgu, you hear the following. Like, almost instantly the door is closed, you hear. And then, almost perfectly timed, you hear Boz go, I was looking for that. But at that point, you're just like, nope.
Like, he's gonna turn and be like, nope. Nope.
Okay.
So what do you wish to do during your shift?
So So he's going to spend a bit of time cleaning his light pistol because he hasn't had a chance to. Also cleaning his vibro sword.
Okay, so just going about cleaning his gear?
Yep.
For that, just to see how much you get done, roll a dex. Because, you know,
dex check.
Yep.
14.
You get to the vibroblade, sword, whatever, and you're just about through disassembling the pistol when the stuff you're using to clean it runs out and you need to go find more.
Oh, son of a... Job of the Hutt's ballsack. Where is it? Klorgu will go and check the utility compartment.
Okay. Let's see. You do find some. Not a lot, but some.
Enough?
I'd say just about enough. But on your way back, you actually notice a door that you hadn't opened before. Well, you haven't seen anyone open it either. Do you wish to look inside of it?
Yes.
Okay. You open the door to find the meditation pool. Are you going to continue your shift, or are you going to just jump in the pool and just zen out for a bit?
All right. Low, I'll go back to my shift.
Okay.
Middle, I finish cleaning, then I go to the pool.
Okay.
High, I go straight for the pool.
Go ahead. The dice like you?
Hold up. I'm gonna get a Beskar fist to the face for this.
I am suddenly scared for this, but go on.
Look in the group chat. I rolled a 19.
Wow. Just remember, Phaisa has, I mean, last shift is Phaisa's.
But that means Boz has his own shift too.
I don't think Boz is going to be using the jacuzzi. That'd be the most funniest thing to walk in. That'd be the funniest thing for Phaisa to walk in on. A droid and jacuzzi. Okay, I'm done. Just goes right back to bed.
Are that droids like oil baths, not water baths?
I'm gonna have to roll again purely because there are multiple. Okay, you know what? That's fine. I'm okay with that. I had to roll again because I could see him doing multiple things.
Lions!
So he is gonna finish cleaning his pistol.
Okay.
And reassemble it and such. And he's kind of going to look around the ship, going like, and scumper off to the meditation pool.
All right. But
he's going to take the orb, well, the stone.
You're going to pull it. Are you going to pull Harry Potter?
Not exactly, no.
Okay.
In his mindset, he knows, like...
Okay, I see where you're going.
He knows that these pools just calm the fuck out of anyone.
I get you.
So he's going to try the mind shit again, but knowing that this pool will help he's like, okay, maybe I just need to be calm when I do this.
Okay, roll a wisdom once you have properly dressed for the pool, because not yours, you dress appropriately for someone else's hot tub.
Yes.
And roll a wisdom.
I gotta get advantage? It is called a meditation pool, and technically...
Yes, I'll give you advantage because it is a meditation pool. just be thankful I'm not making you roll to see if you had a bathing suit.
It's a yacht. They won't have some on hand.
That moment you wake up, Phaisa, do you guys have bathing suits on here? What?
Why do you want...
Phaisa just be like, first of all, I have no helmet on. Get out.
You see my face, I must now kill you.
And no one heard a sound because Boz's noises were filling the ship.
16. So he's holding the stone and the crystal.
The stone warms up in your hand. The crystal in the water... You notice it bleeds all the way through to go completely from purple to the blue that it was becoming.
Okay.
As the stone warms up, you feel the familiar feeling you felt before. And you get flashbacks of when you are on Nar Shaddaa with your old friends. Memories of your time in the purple set, as well as shortly before you left, flood your mind, and you could swear you were back there. That's how vivid they are. But before you're able to, like, conclude any of the memories, you are shaken out of the memory. And you are being stared at by Boz, looking down at you. You meditated for the rest of your shift, and you didn't even notice how long you were in there. That's how, like, out of it you got.
Jesus Christ.
For the record, your hands are very pruned. Hey, he was in there for that long.
Boz, can you do me a massive favor?
Anything for you, friend.
That's terrifying.
Can you not speak of this to anyone on the ship, please?
Speak of what?
Thank you. He is going to, with as much dignity as he can muster in this current moment, get out of the pool, grab his shit, and then proceed to his room.
Gonna walk a shame back to his room.
Just hold his things like that really just
covers his chest.
Just like.
Hold on, we have to know. Are there any tattoos on his body? Or was it just his face?
Yeah, no, there are plenty of tattoos on the breast of his body.
This is the
even
first...
on his ass?
He was wearing a bathing suit. Get out of the gutter.
We only see from, all he's wearing is trunks.
Okay, you said all over his body, so I had to ask.
It's fair, she did.
That's for after dark hours.
That's how we find out that Klorgu made his way across the galaxy as a space gigolo. Alright, Buzz, it is your shift. I would say roll perception to see if you hear the noises, but you were making them, so.
Yes.
What do you do on your shift? Do you go back to noise making?
No, that's not the best way to take a watch.
That's so fair.
He'll leave his construction tools in his room. With nothing turned on.
Safety first.
Yeah, safety first. no OSHA violations on the Mythosar.
With me, you'll be in a world of pure OSHA violations.
he'll go to the cockpit, I guess, because that's the best place to keep watch over a ship, I would assume.
Yes.
And he's just gonna sit there so he can keep an eye on everything and take out his fancy new sword and write the sword's name on the flat.
Ah, yes, yes, the name. Do you wish to share the name with the group, or are you going to leave it for another time? Up to you.
Goodness.
Figured I'd, you know, allow you this opportunity if you wanted to share.
I will tell everyone it's in binary.
Okay. We had discussed what it would be, so I know what it is. I just didn't know if you wanted to share it with the group. So many ones.
A lot of ones. And yeah, if it's anyone curious, we actually translated the sword name I wanted into real binary and Jesus.
I think it's like 17 lines.
Yeah.
But every letter is like 8 to 10 ones and zeros.
Yes, that is going on the flat.
That being said,
fit on the hand guard.
That being said, it'd be hilarious if you could like etch some glow in the dark paint or something into that, so when you're swishing it.
Mm-hmm.
Just saying, if you get a little artsy later. Yeah, if you get artsy. Did you want to do anything else while you were at the etching though?
Oh, just lays the sword in his lap while he sat in the cockpit and does that, and that's it.
Okay. We'll say it took you half of the shift to etch everything in. And during the other half, you are able to plug in the coordinates for the last jump after you come out of the different lanes. Meaning you guys are now currently, for those who have the map at home, on the Corellian run on your way to Tatooine. You guys have made it essentially 80% of the way. You're just doing the straight shot and then bank a left to Tatooine. So when your shift ends and Phaisa begins the last shift, she will just have to do the last bits. So when you guys arrive, she'll be at the helm and landing you safely. On your way back, Phaisa back in her gear and, fully awake, happens to notice you casually walking to your room. Does Phaisa say anything?
Did I hear anything while I was asleep?
Roll a perception. Actually, no. Roll roll three perceptions because there were three shifts.
I rolled a natural one for the first one.
Okay.
Okay. Plus perception is 2, so it's a 3 for the first one. 10 for the second. And a dirty 20 for the third.
Okay, so what happened was, the first shift, you were just out.
I zonked out.
All of the stuff that had happened till now, you finally had to catch up with you, and you just, boom, out cold. But you were full. You actually got really well rested in that first half. Like, mm-hmm. You woke up actually rested for the first time in a mm-hmm. while. It could be because of the familiarity of the old room.
Yeah.
Second shift, you swore to God you heard something, but you chalked up to the fact that you might have been dreaming.
Mm-hmm.
The third shift, you distinctly heard power tools, construction gear, and you swear to God that was not a dream.
Oz, what did you do to my ship?
Nothing harmful, I assure you. Would you like to come see? I think it's almost done.
The fear that just crossed her face.
Yes, I would like to come see what you've done on my ship.
Excellent.
Everyone's now taking bets. How's Phaisa going to react? I got 35 quatlus on she kills the droid.
I've got 100 Dartarians that she's just going to be all sort of confused.
All right. Boz, you bring her to your room.
Yes, I do.
Do you over-dramatize the reveal, or you just, you know, boom, button, look at what I did?
Yeah. That second one, I guess, it's not that big of a deal. Just opens the door and comes in, like, gestures towards... nothing severe. He has deconstructed the bed and rebuilt it as a crafting table.
Why, though?
Well, for practical use.
You know, you could have run this by me first before you did it.
Entirely true.
Oh, he can't undo it now, I guess. So.
Well, I could. But. It's just not right now.
Clearly not right now.
For those at home who need to know, with the crafting bench, Oz, or whoever uses it, can spend time off, like, you know, in downtime, creating, repairing, mending, or whatever. For the record, the ship didn't have one till now, so now the ship has essentially a crafting table.
Yes, I could make all items that, like, because I am an engineer, I can literally make 8 lightsabers in 24 hours.
Paige is like, we have an assembly line.
Phaisa's calculating profits right now.
That moment, Phaisa's like, hold on.
The two force users are like, yes, we have someone who can help us construct. Phaisa is already starting on her way to capitalism.
Because the rotary cannon, the minigun, is only 500 credits, I could make a single minigun every day.
For the record, yeah, this is one of those things that he's concerned me about when he brought him up.
I mean, we didn't have one of these on the ship before, and at least you didn't do it to Hondo's room. I'll give you credit for that.
No, of course not. I wouldn't do that to anyone else's room.
You're okay with this just being in your room?
Yes, I didn't much have a need for it. I tried to lay down on the bed and found it fairly unentertaining.
Yeah, I guess beds are kind of unentertaining.
First off,
I'm gonna be in the cockpit if you need me.
Yes. Have a good evening/morning. Being in space and sleeping is weird.
It is. We should be coming up on Tatooine pretty soon, though, and hopefully everyone else will be up by then.
Excellent.
Just seeing, just for Boz's thing, I rolled. Did you actually just hit something? It's not like someone just hit something metal.
I probably smacked my.
Oh, okay.
Against my keyboard.
Oh, okay. Doing all what you did tonight, Boz, did require you to do a power down at some point to actually get a long rest. So.
Yes, I only need a couple hours.
Yes. So this would actually be a point where you actually would sleep.
Yes. I'm still conscious, though, technically. I just roll all perception checks at disadvantage.
Okay, so you're essentially in sentry mode?
Yes.
Okay. Good thing something I learned from Pandelver carried over. Who would have thought?
Yep.
But yes, Phaisa, your shift begins.
All right.
What would you like to do now that you have it to your time to yourself?
I look at the cockpit door. I press a console, a button on the console to lock it.
Okay.
And I take my helmet off again for a bit.
Okay, because you're inside of it. Okay.
Yeah.
I thought you were going to go, like, snoop around the ship. I'm like, oh, what did she do?
Nah.
Okay. So you took off your helmet.
Yeah, because she found the credits that Hondo had hidden by now.
That's true. Doesn't mean she's
Yeah, because they were in his room. Yeah, she'll just hang out in the cockpit and just maladaptive daydream for a bit.
Okay. Roll me a wisdom.
Swell. Oh, okay. 16.
While you're, you know, daydreaming, after the talking with Kierra and all that, you actually have memories from when you were a kid come back to you. You start remembering all the the times you, your mother and Honda would do things. You start remembering seeing your mom pod race a few times. And you kind of just get to have like a wholesome memory lane.
Mm-hmm.
Being on the ship brings you back memories of how your mother would let you run around while her and Honda were on the ship together. You also have memories of telling your mother you wanted to be just like her, but also saying how you heard about this awesome bounty hunter that you really want to live up to, and her giving you a look that said, yeah, okay, let's not
do... Do I recall the bounty hunter's name?
Not right now.
Okay.
Because it's just
this awesome bounty hunter I heard of growing up.
Yeah, because these daydreams, they're kind of just like flowing together. So they're not like lucid memories. They're just like flashes. I would say, though, afterwards, you actually feel a little bit lighter from having the memories that weren't bad once for once.
Mm-hmm.
After so long of all the bad nightmares and all that, tonight was actually happy, like memory lane. Thank God no one's in the room to see it.
Serotonin! Dopamine!
Melatonin, too.
Yeah.
You got all the tonins.
I got all the tonins. I'll say, by the time when the sensor goes off that we're about to approach Tatooine, I'll put my helmet back on, if that's towards the end of the shift.
It is the actual end. The sensor goes off, and you prepare to pull the ship out of hyperspace. And once you see what's ahead of you, you have the memory of, oh crap, I haven't been here since I was a kid. Hopefully that bartender doesn't work.
Yeah.
Or hopefully he's dead.
Yeah. I haven't been back to this planet since I was 14.
It's been a while.
It's been a long 6 years.
Yeah, it's happened. It looks just the way you remember it. The twin suns in the distance casting this planet as a ball of dust that just invites angst.
Mm-hmm.
Do you wish to wake everyone up, or are you just going to let them sleep until you land?
I'll let them sleep in until I land. Well, I might call for Kierra, because she has the data pad for the landing zone.
Well, since you're going to do that, go ahead and call Kierra if you wish while you start the...
I think there should be, like, intercoms to the different rooms, right?
Yep.
All right. I'll just click a button on the console.
Okay.
Kierra, we're entering the atmosphere of Tatooine if you want to come to the cockpit with the data pad so we can find a decent landing zone. Decent docking bay. Yeah, that shit.
Kierra comes out of her room, like, skidding, like, goes to the cockpit.
Just for sake of the skidding, roll a nat 20 just as it is.
Roll a nat 20 as it is.
No stats.
Okay, I'll roll a nat 20.
Yeah, no, and I'll tell you why after.
Okay, just a random 20?
Just a random d20.
I know
you said nat 20, not d20.
Yeah, no, she has to roll nat 20, or this goes badly for her.
Come out of the tower, please. That's a natural 19.
Okay.
Hey, it's close enough.
Thankfully, you weren't so asleep that her waking you startled you. You woke up from your sleep well rested. You wish you could have got a little bit more sleep, though, don't we all? You thought about it, but since you were like, okay, we're just landing, don't worry about it. You don't get fully dressed, you just put on your, like, underclothing instead of the armor.
basically the kind of like robes.
Yeah, the tunic, the pants. You're like, no, we're still on the ship. I don't need the armor. And when you skid out, you don't fall this time.
Sweet.
this time you're actually like coherent enough to be like, whoa, nope. Again. Yeah, I got this.
Got it. She runs
up. Learn from my mistakes.
Here's the question though. Did Phaisa unlock the cockpit door while Kira is running through it?
God, did I?
Hey, Phaisa,
I did. I think I did.
We'll roll. Hannah, high or low?
Oh, God.
Low.
Door wasn't locked, but you were running faster than it opened. So you have to, like, you need to, like, think very thin as you slide in, because you nearly collide with it. You got, it, the roll was 11, so you were, like, one off.
Is hyper.
Sorry. Here you go. She'll hand over the data pad.
Mm-hmm.
Sorry, what time is it? Mm.
The current local time is, we'll say, brunch.
It's just before noon.
Alright.
Wake up. Sit down, wake up. Get us patched in with the tower.
And Phaisa will go through the whole landing process of contacting Mos Eisley Tower.
And
finding a docking bay, that good shit.
The communication comes back. You guys will be given docking bay 94.
Hey!
The last shot of the evening will be the ship coming to a landing. And as it lands, Phaisa and Kira can actually see, scuttling towards the ship, a series of pit droids. Already quickly running to plug in to refuel and check for anything that they need to be fixing. And you guys land without a hitch?
Are we going to meet Pelly?
We'll see next week.
Pelly Motto! I hope we get to meet her.
Oh.
Canonically, Phaisa will have met Pelly Motto before Din has.
If Pelly's at this docking bay.
If Pelly is at this docking bay. But she's known to have pit droids.
She is. You were saying?
Also, I was going to say, Klorgu as a kid was a little shit, because he would always used to boop the pit droids in the most inconvenient times, so, yeah. It's like, oh, nice droid. Boop!
You're an asshole. Got it.
Also, I did the flag, guys, and nice. I said it in the group.
Oh, did you?
Yay!
Let me see.
I'm gonna go to bed.
Yes.
Okay,
to everyone who showed up and watched, I appreciate you guys watching. This will be uploaded to the YouTube for my channel on Friday. Paige will be this weekend.
I have actually said it that my episodes upload the next Wednesday
okay.
at noon.
Okay, that works.
Yeah.
But yes.
Because I always forget to upload on the weekends.
That's true. But yes, thank you all for coming. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this week's session. We will see you guys next time. From all of us, may the force be with you, and have a good night, guys. Bye.
Everyone, good night on my channel as well. May the force be with you. Mwah. Bye.
Good night.